Okay, let's see how we can add a couple of tracks to our empty Cubase project. This is actually very simple. You click here on the plus sign to add a track. Now let's first add an audio track. So we put audio, then we say the configuration is stereo, so we could also make it mono, but in our case we select stereo. We don't mind about the audio inputs because we are not going to do a recording today. The audio output should be left to stereo out or whatever that is called in your configuration, so that you have sound on your monitors. And the name, let's say that was R&B vocal, and then we say add track. Now it is as simple as that. So now we have the R&B vocal audio track, which you see here from the wave symbol. You can make it larger or smaller with your mouse, and we can also color it. So let's give this a color. So this palette on the top in your toolbar is where you can select colors. So you can open this. So this may look a little bit different in your case, but you will see different colors that you can select. And then let's say we choose a color, and that's how we color this track. Now, before we put any content, let's now also add the instrument tracks from the basics project. So we again do plus, and we have three instrument tracks, but we will add them one by one. Or let's do first the groove agent. So the instrument was groove agent SE, MIDI inputs, audio is again set to stereo out, and we name this groove agent. And we add two tracks with this groove agent instrument. So we say add track, and there it is. And you see that here in the white zone. Now we have a virtual instrument added, groove agent, and another one, groove agent. So this one, this track corresponds to this virtual instrument, as you can see, because it is now highlighted. And this track corresponds to this virtual instrument. Now let's color them. So now we can select both. So you click on the track and then you do shift click. Now you have selected both tracks. You can also do it one by one. And we select the colors again and give it a particular color, yellow. Now, so that is the two groove agent tracks. And now we have the Hadion track, another virtual instrument. So we say plus, we select the instrument. But now we have to select Hadion. Okay, my mouse is a little bit slow, but here it is, Hadion Sonic. Again, to stereo out. The inputs are not really important now. And we say, well, this is Hadion. Let's call it piano. Then we know that this won't be a piano sound. Air track. Now, again, you see that the Hadion instrument is now added here in the white zone. And we have the track, which is called piano. And again, we can give it a color. And I always make these pianos blue. Okay. Now we have already our four tracks. You also see here input-output channel. So this is a folder track, as it is called. You can also, I think, a little bit resize that or open it. But don't remove any of the tracks that you find in there. Just leave them as is. And I tend to drag them always at the bottom of my project. Okay, now we need to add content. So the R&B vocal. So what you can do in the white zone, you now go to media, you select loops and samples, and then there are many wave files to choose from, but you can, the easiest for now is to just search. So you say R&B, vocal, phrase, and we had number 14 in our project. So if you click on
kinda
this,
love it, kinda crazy, kinda stupid,
you will already be able to hear what it sounds like. But now we take it up with the mouse and drag it to the project, to this particular track, the first one, R&B vocal. Now, and there it is, and you can move it around with your mouse. So for example, we can start at the third measure if you want. Now, there are a couple of things to see here. So this was recorded with 150 beats per minute. And we see that our project tempo is 120, so this doesn't match, which is not that that much of a problem. But if you are going to add our groove agent content, then the groove agent will play back in the project tempo, which is 120 beats per minute, but the vocal will basically sing with a tempo of 150. Now this can very easily be solved. So you select this event, that is what we just have put in our project, and we then select musical mode. So we click on this, and now it is automatically, you see that it was a little bit extended because it is now being played back in a slower tempo. So now this event fits the tempo of the project. If you don't see this this bar on top of your project window, then you can always enable this by disabling or enabling the info line. So you go to this cogwheel here, which is for the configuration, where you can select all the things that you want to see. Okay. Now, what we could also have done is, instead of first making this audio track, to just pick up the sample from the media browser and then just move it in the project window at a place different than the tracks that were selected, and then it will automatically add a different track, audio track, for you. So that it was a little bit more simpler, but that is not what we did now. And again, you may work it to any position that you want to, and you can align the events. Now, we are not going to use this one, so we click on it, we right click on it with the mouse, and then we say remove selected tracks, or you can do shift del, then it will also remove, and we say yes, and then it is gone. Okay, so now we need content for two of the tracks. So we had content for the piano, and we had content for the groove agent. Now let's first do the piano. So the piano was a virtual instrument, so we again click here on VSTi, which are the virtual instruments, and this is connected to Hardium. You see that, because if we click on this one, then also this Hardium instrument will be highlighted. And you can also see that in the left zone. So this symbol, the keyboard here, denotes the instrument, and you see that it is connected to Hardium Sonic. So you can always check to what instrument an instrument track is connected to. Now, by clicking on the channel editor, so edit instrument here on the E, we can also do that here, you will open the instrument. Here it is also, there are always multiple ways of doing this in Cubase, so edit instrument. It is here or here. So if you open this, we get Hadion. And then you can select a piano. So you will see fewer instruments than in my case. But you have a sonic selection. And if you look for piano, so you can just type it in. Then you can, for example, select one of these preset acoustic ground piano, double click, and then it will be loaded in this slot. And now you have a piano sound in this instrument. So that's all that you have to know for now. So you can select different sounds. You have strings, you have electric pianos, organs, all kinds of synthesizer sounds, etc. But you see that we have now selected a piano. So we can click away this window. And now this track is connected to a piano sound. Now, we still don't have any content. So we now select the draw tool. So there are different ways for adding content, but we will do it now very simple. We select the draw tool here, the pencil tool, and you just click with the mouse and drag to the end of this bar 11 in this case, so that it has a length equal to the vocals. Okay, and then you select the object selection tool again. Now, so now we have added an other event, but this is still empty. Now, we will explain at a later stage how we can now add content that makes sense. But if you double click or here do open key editor, that has the same thing. So we say open key editor. Then you will have something like this. I will remove, don't bother about all these lower tracks, lanes, if you see them. But you see here the piano keyboard going from C-2 to all up to C8. So that's how the notes are called. And again, with the pencil tool, you can now draw in certain notes, positions where you like. And you see that this area is a little bit more dark than the rest. So this corresponds to the event that we just had in our main window. Okay, if you are done, so now we have different notes. You can click away this window and then you see it also appearing in this event. So now if we do solo, we click in this ruler bar, so the cursor will be set to the beginning, and we say play. So then you hear the piano playing. So now we have content for our piano. So the next thing to do is to add content for Groove Agent. So let's take the second one. So you see that it is connected to this virtual instrument. So we can open this again by clicking on the Edit Instrument, the E button here. And that will open Groove Agent. So Groove Agent is a drum computer. And the first thing that we have to do is to load a drum kit. So if you click on the kit here, then you will see something like this. You also will see SE Studio Kit. So you can select that, and then you can select one of the presets. I'll just take the first one, Break Me Down in my case, and double click, and then this will be loaded in a similar way as with the Hadion instrument. And then you see, well, this is the drum kit. So if you click on the toms, then you will actually hear it playing. You can also push the buttons, so you see kick, side stick, snare, claps, the different toms. So that's how you do it. So that is the instrument. And if you click on pattern, then you have pre-programmed drum patterns that you can trigger. So if you, for example, click on main, then you will hear a specific pattern playing. Now what you can do is to click here on this pattern and just drag it into your project in the track with Groove Agent 2. And then click away this window. And now you have actually copied this pattern directly in your project. So you can play again, you do solo, and there it is. And you can again double click on this, and then you will see the key editor again with the different notes that are played. To trigger this drum kit, well, this is not very informative because we are looking at a drum kit and not at a piano. So it is better to go to MIDI and open drum editor. And then you will see something like this. And then you see exactly the time at which the bass drum is played, the snare drum, the hi-hat, and also a crash. So, and then you, like before, you can also change this pattern to play in different rhythm. But that's not what we are going to do. Now, and this kind of reconstructed the basic project that you started with. So now if you play it all together, and let's just mute this. And hit play.
Kinda love it, kinda crazy, kinda stupid, cause I'm in the deep end.
Now, and that is how you can then add tracks and add content. I hope that this makes sense and that this helps you in adding different tracks to your project. And keep in mind, if you click the plus button, then you see that there are many more track types available. So now we only used audio and instrument, but there are also MIDI tracks, for example, folder tracks. We have group tracks, effect tracks, so that's what we will see later. And you can always configure what they have to do. Okay, thank you, and see you in the next video.